This video will cover some common troubleshooting issues when using a Boca Lemur printer. The first one we'll discuss is the printer not displaying in the discovered printers list, which would be this section here. So with a Boca Lemur printer setup, you will always have to manually input the IP address of the printer. So you'd always have to first obtain that IP address from the test printout. Let's say that my printer was not connected, so I'm going to go ahead and forget the printer. So always have to enter in that IP address. Once I've entered it, then I can tap to select it and it will connect. If after you've entered the IP address for the Boca and the iPad or iOS device is giving you an error message to try connecting again, you'll want to ensure that your iOS device is connected to the same network that your printer is connected to. Once you ensure that, you can go back into the printer settings of the Organizer app and re-enter the IP address and connect the device. If after printing out the test ticket, you do not see an IP address listed in the IP add field of the ticket, that means that you have not given the printer enough time to obtain the IP address from the internet source. So make sure that you're waiting at least 3 minutes for the printer to obtain that IP address before proceeding. The next thing that you can do is power cycle the printer, again waiting at least 3 minutes for the printer to obtain the IP address. The third thing that you want to do if you're still not getting an IP address, and that means if it's displaying as 000.000 and so forth, is it might be an issue with the network itself or the internet source hardware. So you can try replacing the network cable that's either feeding into the internet port of the router or the Ethernet port into the printer itself. You can also try a different port on the router, or lastly, you can try power cycling the network equipment to see if that resolves. If at any time you receive a printing problem error message or a message that reads something's not quite right, it could be a few different things. So first thing, make sure that the tickets, you're printing in batches of 100 tickets or less. Also, make sure that the device is not going to sleep during the print time. And an easy way to ensure that is to go into the device settings, go to display and brightness, and then tap auto lock, and then hit never, and then continue to print your order. The next thing that you could do with that, if neither of those resolves, is power cycle the printer and then disconnect and reconnect the printer. The next issue we'll take a look at is when you're printing, the print option becomes grayed out. So this means that the printer has become disconnected from the selling device. The first thing that you want to check is to make sure that the selling device is still on the same network as your printer. So if it's not, that's an easy fix. Select the correct network. If it is, you'd want to next check to see if your printer IP address has changed for any reason. So to do that, you would print a test ticket and read that IP add field on the test ticket and make sure that it's the same as the IP address that you entered originally. And if it's not, go into the printer settings and update and put the new IP address for the printer. Reconnect, and then you can go continue to print. The next issue that we'll take a look at is content alignment for the actual printout of the ticket. So if you notice that the items on the ticket itself are not aligned correctly, the first thing to check is to make sure that the ticket stock itself is aligned and fed through properly into the printer. The second thing that you'd want to do is power cycle the printer, disconnect the printer from the Eventbrite Organizer app, and then reconnect and try printing again. If those two things do not resolve the issue, it could be a firmware version issue with the Boca itself. So what you would need to do is print a test ticket and then send that to your client services rep to resolve. Another issue you may come across is a paper jam or paper out error message. And when that happens, you'll actually see the Boca LCD display that message on the side. So to fix that, you would just want to either, if it's paper out, obviously feed more stock, or if it's paper jam, you would just want to take the stock out and reinsert. And there you go. The next issue we'll discuss is constant ticket or paper jams. So if you're constantly getting paper jams, it may mean that you need to clean the Boca itself. Also, if your tickets are coming out smudged or faded or smeared in any way after they print, it could also mean that the Boca rollers need to be cleaned. So we'll take a look at how to clean those rollers. If you do suspect that the Boca rollers need to be cleaned, you can easily clean them by removing the two screws that are on the side of the Boca. So one here, second one there, and you just need a small Phillips to remove the top. Once the top is removed, you can take a look. You'll see a black lever that reads lift to open, snap to close. So you'll have to lift that, and then you'll remove this silver piece here by pulling it forward and bringing it up. I'm just gonna have a light here so you guys can see where the roller is. That's where the roller is, and you just want to use alcohol, rubbing alcohol, and a damp cloth to clean that of any debris. Once you have, I'm going to replace this in, and then you're going to snap that on. You can also use any compressed air that you may have to clean this out. Once you've done so, go ahead and replace the top and screw in both screws. If after cleaning the problem still is there or persisting, the Boca may need to be sent for a roller replacement. So again, contact your client services rep to address the issue. The last issue that you may come across is one that reads on the LCD screen as Opto Error. So if you see Opto Error, that means that the Boca needs to be repaired, and you'll need to contact your client services rep to arrange that repair.